Welcome to Getting Started with the DevExpress Scheduler for Blazor. In this video, I'll show you how to build a simple Blazor application with a scheduler component. I'll set up three different scheduler views and populate the component with different appointment types: one time, all day, and recurrent. I've already created a new Blazor application and configured it to use DevExpress components. To learn how to do this, you can watch the videos from the links in the description. First, let's add a scheduler component to the application. I go to pages/index.razor and add the DX scheduler open and close tags to the page. Next, let's bind the scheduler to data. I've already declared an appointment class for an appointment that is rendered in the scheduler, and an appointment collection class, this is a data source, for the scheduler. In the Razor at code block, I create a DX scheduler data storage object and set up the appointment source property to fill the storage with a collection of data objects. Then I set up the appointment mappings property. I create a DX scheduler appointment mappings object and map data source fields to appointment properties. Finally, I assign the data source to the scheduler's data storage property. Now I need to add views to the scheduler. I add a DX scheduler week view object to the markup and run the app. As you can see, the scheduler displays 1 week at a time, including non-working days. There are one-time appointments and all-day appointments. The scheduler highlights the current day and shows a line that indicates the current time. Let me add more views, a day view and work week view. And run the app again. The scheduler now displays the day view because it's defined first in the markup. To switch between views, I use the view selector. Each view has customization settings. For example, I set up the show work time only property for all views. You can see that all the views display only work hours, 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. Let's specify other settings for the day view. I remove the show work time only property, specify the number of days displayed in the view, and set the time scale interval to 1 hour. Now I set work time. I create the DX scheduler time span range object that allows me to specify a time interval. Then I set the visible time interval. Finally, I hide the current time indicator. And let's take a look at that in the browser. You can see that the view displays 3 days at a time. The visible time is 8 a.m. to 7 p.m. Work time is 9 a.m. to 6 p.m. Time cells outside the work time interval have a gray background. Now let's look at how to create recurrent appointments. First, I declare a recurrence field in the appointment object and map this field to the appointment's recurrence info property. Now I can create recurrent appointments in the scheduler. Let's take a look. I click an empty cell in a view. This invokes the compact appointment form. Here I can specify the appointment caption, daily meeting, start, and end time. For this recurrent appointment, I need to specify a recurrence rule. I click the expand arrows button to open the full appointment form. In the repeat field, I select daily and specify the rule. This event will repeat every 1 day and end after 5 occurrences. I also specify the appointment label and status. The newly created appointment is marked with the recurrent icon. It repeats from Monday to Friday. The appointment label is displayed as an appointment's background color, cyan. The appointment status is displayed as a colored strip on the left edge of the appointment. To delete the appointment, I click the delete button and select delete series. You can also create recurrent appointments in code. I'll create the same daily meeting appointment. I go to a data source, add a new appointment to it, and initialize the recurrence field in this way. Here I specify the recurrence rule. And let's run this one last time. Here is my recurrent appointment. And that's it for this video. I hope you've enjoyed this tutorial on the DevExpress Blazor Scheduler component. If you like this video, give us a thumbs up. If you have any questions, please comment below. And don't forget to subscribe and ring the bell so you can get notified anytime we release new content. Thanks for watching, and thank you for choosing DevExpress.